Sri Aurobindo has written, the ascent to the divine life is the human journey, the work of works, the acceptable sacrifice. This and only this is man's real work in the world. And then he becomes very humorous. And he says, otherwise we would be like an insect on a speck of mud that somehow managed to form itself amid the appalling immensities of the universe. So here in the Om Choir, we are on the human journey. Through sound, through the power of sound, and even more so, through the power of Om. Each week, we listen to a piece of new music. And tonight, it is a piece by Morten Lauritsen, or Nata Lux. Lauritsen lives near Puget Sound, north of Seattle, and has an old piano, lives alone, and he composes the most beautiful music. One of his works that is performed all over the world are five pieces that he set to music of the French poems of Rilke, On the Rose. So I hope you'll all have an opportunity to listen to that soon. And tonight we begin with O Nata Lux. And from there, we'll begin the Om Choir. These pieces of music are not for us to emulate and to replicate, but to be inspired so that we free up our consciousness, not containing it in this small self, but uniting it with this greater self that seems to grow more and more each week. And that to me is a sign of the opening to the new consciousness. Or not a book.
Oh.
the third note. In 1-3-5.
want to try something quite different now. Each section will roll into the next section, like this.
Sit in a circle, and we have many circles. Have no preconceived idea as to what will come down. She further said, there is a music just above the head, waiting to descend. And it's a new music, a music that has not been heard on the earth before. And we have that privilege. Being in her presence and the presence of Sri Aurobindo here tonight, who are blessing this work, sanctioning it, and pouring all their help and grace into this collective soul, because we are not individuals here. And we should not think of ourselves as small, closed-in individuals, but as part of a group soul that descends on earth to advance the evolution. It's sacred duty. It's sacred work. So as we concentrate for a few moments, remember that these techniques are only to assist the awareness of the body consciousness. And we don't have time, although we have people here for many years, we don't have time with everyone to teach breathing, to teach the different parts of the body that go into singing, but we open spontaneously to that higher grace and just aspire to be instruments of the divine force and the divine music.
discovering new notes of the eternal theme. One force shall be your mover and your guide. One light shall be around you and within.
Thank you. This word was seed of all things to be.
Thank you. Then, falling silent in self to know, he meets the deeper listening of his soul. The word repeats itself in rhythmic strains.
Thank you.
like a chant with many tones, immense and various, like a universe.
Voices move as the divine wills them. No fear. That's the first condition. No judgment. That's the second. Because our aspiration rises up, and only the Lord can judge our music, our offering, our aspiration, and our surrender. Allow yourself